because the habitat has improved, we see a need for doing a trout and fish community study on the Saluda River. What we think is happening is that with these improvements, we're going to see better growth and survival of trout, and we're also going to see positive improvements in the total fish community, including the striped bass. In the study, we're going to look at the entire Saluda River from the Lake Murray Dam all the way down to below the zoo. We're going to do a tag return study, and one of these tags is going to be inserted into a fish, and that fish will represent a tagged fish, and you just put it in and pull it out. And so there'll be tagged fish swimming in the river, and we're going to be looking at what angler returns on the tags are. In other words, we're going to be looking at anglers who report back to us that they've caught fish with tags in them. And we're going to do a creel survey where we're going to send a creel clerk out on the river to question fishermen on a number of various perspectives of their fishing trip.
The goals of the creel survey will be to determine angler preference and angler success on the Lower Saluda River. This will be done through a series of questions. I'll ask anglers how many they've caught, what species they've caught. I'll be taking the weight and the length of those fish. If there's any tagged fish, I'll be recording that data and going from there.
We have envelopes that will be provided at drop box locations along the river, and basically you just put the tag in the envelope, fill out the information on the envelope, and put it in the drop box. Another way to return information on a tag is that we have an interactive website form, and you can just fill out the interactive website form. And a third way is that we will have staff in the river and around the river, and you can always give these tags to any of our staff that you see on the river. We are partnering with the Saluda chapter of Trout Unlimited. They're helping us by volunteering to help tag the fish at the Walhalla Fish Hatchery, and also by providing rewards for the tag returns.
We're going to give $3,000 a year to help with the study and to try to give everybody a cap who turns in a tag, and to try to encourage people to be responsive to the, you know, the returning of the tags. And we will also look at trying to assist DNR in any way, other ways we can.
If you have any questions about how to do tag returns, there's a phone number on the tag, and you can call that number and you'll get instructions on what to do.